name the Tower of Bone. Alright, game. I just had to go fight some dragons real quick for some cool loot. Ooh, I think the last dragon gives you some really cool, Does it give you some really cool mage armor? I would be very sad if it didn't. Oh, I should have brought... no, okay, we'll bring Blackwall back later. Gotta bring back Blackwall back to go to the thingy. To go to the Val Shaka's watch. I think to claim the Tower of Bone, they make you go, like, up really high, but I'm not actually sure. Oh, no, there's, like, a bunch of dudes to fight in here. I think. Maybe. Maybe not. Oh. I see some. Ah, I see you! Perfecto! There's only one of you here. Interesting. Superior Battlemaster coat. That was a very delayed reaction, guy. No idea about the loot from this dragon. I think I just made an Inquisition camp while there are still enemies around? Yes? No? Travel the Suladin Keep! Freaky, let's see if I can get there. There's a high possibility that I won't. Where is it? Where the freak is it? Let me zoom out. Okay. All right, off y'all this way. There's the keep. Like, we've just like set up camp like in the middle of Lyrium. It's great. You die. I tried to dodge that. That was rude. You know what? Dang it, I can't do that ability yet. Yeah, you're all panicked. I'm like three archers in a row here. It's ridiculous. Cassandra looks so cool. Alright, guy, alright. You dead now? Yeah, what is it? What is it? Where is it?
It sings sick music.
Bringing coal here is scary. Don't mind me, I'm just jumping all over Red Lyrium. Oh yeah, this is about the treasure or something. There's treasure in the rubble. Is this a Grey Warden thing? Oh no, it's Mama's ring. Okay. Oh, there's loot too. I should loot the dudes. Dale's loading wool. Excellent. Gold, not excellent. Plush pristine velvet, excellent. Wow, this bed is like legit. Snow. Ooh, cool. treasure keep. Some of the most intact ruins we see here, elven ruins. Oh crap, it's that guy! Hey guy, come back! You're not dead, don't die, man! Are you gonna die, man? Cause you're not allowed to die. He has zero health right now, but he's still somehow managing to run around. Cassandra helping him out. Nice. Cassandra would help him out. Yo, guy, you coming? Michael.
Bad news, Harald. Your efforts to drive off the Red Templars have not gone unnoticed. Imshael knows we're here. He sent Red Templars after me, and a pack of shades descends now upon Sarnia. The people are defenseless. I must return without delay. It's up to you to destroy Imshael.
Why don't I just go back? Why don't I just go back? And then you deal with Imshael. Seriously. I mean, that's noble of you and all, but... Guy. Why don't I remember every loot drop? Why don't anybody remember them all? I try to memorize the dragon ones. Just so I can be like, yeah, yes, this is the one here and here. Nope. All I remember is the two Empress dragons drop. One of them drop cool scout armor. And then the one in Crestwood drops a piece of Grey Warden armor. Imshael, I'm coming for you! I like you, Imshael. You're a fiend. A right fiend. I think I need to loot as I go. I can't remember. Broken filter. I don't need a broken filter. Oh, that's the Red Lyrium thingy, though. Wow, I brought coal for this. This was a bad idea. Shoot, did we? Okay, good. We do have potions still. Okay. Bringing coal was a bad idea. He's gonna die so quick. But I wonder what he'll say about Imshael. Last time I brought Solas and Sarah, and this is one of the times where I got the really cool dialogue that Solas is like trying to like coax magic almost out of Sarah. It's really interesting. Yeah, here be giants. This is where you figure out what the Red Templars are trying to do to the giants. Cole, have a potion, Cole. Also, Cole, actually. Yeah, why not? Have one of those. Is it me? Okay. You always take the purchase offer! That doesn't even do anything, does it, though? Like, he's just like, oh, just kidding. And then he just runs away. But then Michael dies. And you don't... Otherwise, he could be an asset. If you keep him alive. Make sure I'm not... Whoop. Paragon's Luster, thanks. One piece of Paragon's Luster. Freshman! The Imshael encounter is great. I wish you could have, like, a cutscene for it, like, and get a really close-up look on him. Oh! Okay. So don't keep documents. Do we know anything about that Imshael fellow? Where did he come from? Why are we to defer to him? He's not from the Order, so as far as I know, there's something... So as far as I know, and there's something about him that makes me uneasy. Oh, somebody still had a bit of brain. I want to get more of the Suladin documents this time. I think I only got a couple. Oh, okay, he doesn't give you virgins. So you just fight him anyway. You're like, oh, rude! That's so rude. If you asked for virgins, they should have, like, I don't know, thrown some desire demons at you. But no, we don't have desire demons in this game, except for Imshael! He is the only male desire demon that you ever meet. Writing has become difficult. There's sharp pain in my hands when I move them, like shards of glass on my knuckles. When I look in the mirror, I don't recognize myself. I remember when Lieutenant Erasmus got this way. He looked like a living corpse, his complexion like a facsimile of the blush of life. Instead of blood, it was pulsing red lyrium. It killed him and kept him alive at the same time. I don't want this anymore. It gave me power, but it goes against everything I was taught. Sometimes I'm swept along in the fervor, but in the quiet, I remember what I was and what I believed. Some say Imshel can cure us. He can pull the red lyrium from our bodies if we ask him, but there's a price. No price would be too high. I just want to be myself again. Yeah, I think the price is your life. Pretty sure.
Kill.
Dang it. Missed it. Here we go.
Let none survive.
Jumpy, jumpy, jumpy. Oh. I feel like a giant's gonna pop up behind my back any second now. Yeah, get this archer out of the way. Good job, Cole. Actually, we can kill you all. That's the great thing about it all. I am loving this bow looking all fiery on my back. It was right here. It was this area where... Oh, Sarah said something about... She's like, wait, I've seen this before. And she was like having like a deja vu moment. It was weird. I have to put him down. Oh, we must be... Is it the last one? It being the ogre. Surely the behemoth says our purposes. Yep, they're trying to freaking corrupt freaking ogres. It's ridiculous. The giant brought from the Emerald Greys last week died this morning. Had a small injury to the abdomen that eventually killed it. No one has spotted a female of the species. Interesting. It never says what that price is, just that someone would rather die than pay it. I wonder if it's the death of, like, somebody else that you know. You know what I mean? Aimshale drives a very difficult bargain, and he is very cunning, at least in the book. Like, oh my gosh. You don't really get to see that in the...
They want to be big, to kill everything.
The giants do? Oh, by the way, Frograder, I don't know what, if you saw it, but yeah, I got the unlocking thing. What was the point of unlocking this? There's nothing in here. To get a closer look at the... Whoa. It's... Look at its eyes! Oh my gosh! Its eyes are so scary! Oh, buddy! Oh, buddy! That's scary! It's good. Talon needed to be able to pick locks because freaking... What kind of thief would he be, or what kind of rogue would he be otherwise? Sweet, so I could open those up, and nothing happened. Man, this place is gorgeous. I haven't fully explored the Empress in PC version either. Freaking, one of my favorite things in video games is snow. I don't know what it is, but I just freaking love the snow. And if I had to choose seasons for each of my characters, Erica would be spring, Talon would be winter, and my human noble Asha would be summer. Still working on a fall character. Gotta find one that fits fall properly. Yeah, nice. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. You're dead. I cannot kill you all, but I can kill a bunch of you one at a time. Oh, call. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. No, no, no. We're definitely targeting the face. We're definitely targeting the ogre. Infected giant. Yes. Shoot. I don't have my ability yet. Okay. My big damage dealer. I don't have Solas with me! Okay, fine. Trying to run up and get him from the front, so it's basically useless. Dodge, 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 dodge. Oh, he's after me! He's after me! Oh my gosh, he's coming for me! He's coming for me! not the morgue that's the problem. It's the little big guy over there. Oh my gosh, you just hit me with a rock! I was not paying attention! Okay, okay, hold up. Okay, you guys need to assist. Wait, no, 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 no. Nope, that was the wrong way. Totally the wrong way.
Dorian!
Dorian! Did you hear me cry for my lover? Come back, lover! He's only 19. Blah, blah, blah. Seasons in the next. Oh my gosh, yes. Did he die? Oh, he's not dead yet. But he's just sitting there. Okay, there we go. Got rid of him, at least. Alright. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Yeah, Cole died. Yes, he did. Alright, now are you dead?
More of us than you know.
Oh, hey, you guys are still around. You're still here. That's nice. Did not realize that. Poor Cole.
A little bird tells me you might be up for the sunburst throne, Cassandra.
Oh.
I suppose you'd prefer to see a man in the position.
Oh!
You'd certainly be a first step towards.
That will be less amusing should it actually come to pass.
You'd be mad to consider it. Can you imagine the target it would place on you?
I don't want to think about that right now.
Did he actually mean? I think he actually meant that, like as in like, not just joking around with her, but being like, would you seriously, like, you can't do that, like that would be so, you would not be safe, you know. Because Dorian cares. Dorian cares deeply. They've been very chatty lately. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. I think this is the longest keep. Like, it is a grueling trudge. Wait a second. Is this... Okay, I don't know. Call me Imshel. Man, I wish this was like a bigger deal, like, I don't know. Is it something up there? Whoop. Yeah! Look at that! Abyssal peach, not so much for the distress, should be kept in a cold, dark place, also locked, forgotten as well, if one is wise. There's a little tiny elven statue. I've never seen a small version. Interesting. That's cool. Whoa! Whoa! Here's the other giant. Holy crap! Wow! It just died in a tent? And it's like putting off horrible vibes. Reed. Everyone makes you uneasy. He's talking back to Hayden. Calm down. What I hear is Imshel was sent to help oversee Red Lyrium growth in the quarry. He supports the cause. That's all that matters. Keep your nose down. Do your job. And don't antagonize him. Hayden, you had a chance, buddy. Should have run when you had the chance. Stormheart. Nice. It's just Arbor Blessing, right? Yeah. It's funny you don't ever see big stat. I don't think you see big statues of like elven warriors or mages even. You only ever see like one of those statues though. One of those statues would for sure be in the elven decor. One of these would definitely be in the elven decor. This way? Come on! Oh my gosh, just let me through! Ah! And one of these! These would also definitely be in there. One of the, like, maybe a big version of the Hala statue and the Dalish wolf statue. Ah, got you dead. You're dead. Ouch, ouch. Should have gotten. Wait, are you a longsword guy? That's what I. Whoa, buddy. Whoa! Put me on a shield. Holy, where's the freaking archer? Red Templar marksman. You get the mark of death, Bucky. Dorian has a comment when you hand over the manuscript to Frederick? I need to do that. Burning and fear. Wait, no. Okay. Yes. Oh, didn't have it yet. Okay. Detonate. You're dead. You're not dead. Die now. Okay.
Help Dorian!
Perfect. Oh, wow. You guys are... Are you guys going to, like, is there, there's a giant in there, and you've gone to encounter it without me, haven't you? How nice. Yep. Wow, though, how did Cole get help? Or guard, I mean. Wow, it's just right there. It is right there. If I could get it from here. Okay, come back this way. You schizophrenic. No, Dorian! Dorian, you're an idiot! Let me see if I can. I can't. Oh, let's try. Nope, not for everybody. No. Whatever. Oh, yeah, you can fast forward. I forgot. Well, Dorian, if you're just determined to die. Your business. Perfect. And Cole. Jeez Louise. Do you have... Read that. Oh, first blight, chapter 4. Cole, get back in the circle of love. I didn't give Cassandra Horn of Valor yet. I gave her, I'm working on it, but I haven't given it to her yet. So I must have given, I think Cole has a dagger that actually gives him guard. I picked up a really cool dagger in the Jaws of a Con DLC. We were running around in there earlier. But it must be the dagger that's giving him guard. Loot! There's a ton of notes to read. I was in Karkwall when Meredith died. She drew the Red Lyrium upon the Red Lyrium at her sword and was consumed by it. Himshel knows something. He calls himself a gardener. Is that how he sees it? Tends to the Red Lyrium, keeping it well fed and growing, not too quickly, not too slowly. There's a soldier in Sarnia, calls himself Michael. Told people you are a demon. A demon, what a frightful thing to call someone. No, leave him alone. He made his choice. I look forward to seeing his attempts to follow through, although I suspect he'll trip on his good intentions and fall down a well inside a week. Yep. Michael made his choice. And that's the thing about Imshale, is he likes to give you a choice. What the heck? What are you doing up there? He likes to give you a choice and see how you react to it. What is this, like, little parkour zone? Like, holy crap. Like, how do you even do that? Imsha lit the way for us. What's up with this? That looks like a Kunari. That looks like a Kunari. It's got the horns. Can I get? No, I can't. Look at that though. That's got the horns of a Kunari. But it's in an elven keep. Oh my gosh, that is so cool! Wow, that is interesting. You're looking for Gurren corpses out in Western Approach. So Bull says how many? How many do you need to lure out? Two Hydras! You're like, Bull, shut up! Oh, and it's that, woman again. With, like, the demon on her head. And then a guy with horns similar. Interesting! Interesting. Where you at? I saw you. Wow, this place is gorgeous. You know what would be really cool in elven decor? If you could, like, bring snow in. Like, it's like, you know how, like, magic is, like, life? Like the elves used to be able to, like, live and breathe magic, basically. Like, it'd be so cool to have that be a part of... Wow, there's a bunch of Felindars in here. To have that be a part of things. Dang it, I just ran out of stealth. If you guys knock me off of this, I will be so angry. Oh shoot, we're in the way of coal. I think I'm not in the way of Dorian. Oh hey, there's a guy up here. I like can't even reach him basically. Got him. You want that in Skyhold? I know. It would be so cool to like have like the weather change in Skyhold. A room that was always snowing. And like a room that was always blooming. It would be so cool. I remember hearing vaguely that a lot of people were disappointed that... Because like I remember when Inquisition was like being advertised that like... You were supposed to have actually really incredible control over the environment itself. Like, you could over-harvest an area type thing. Or you could hunt out an animal, basically. And, like, it would take a much longer time to recover. But that is not the case. But I remember that was what was promised. It would just be cool, like, if I don't know. There was just so much... Right, it's always cool if there could be so much more in a game. And I'm sure that they initially, when they were making the game, were like, freaking, yeah, let's have a room that's snowing. And like, when you're in the pre-planning stage, like, anything is... fair game, you know? But... Hello, Imshel! Save. Yeah, we'll save over that. Shame they cut that out. I know. You guys are so strange. The less snow you see, you're like, well, okay, in real life, I like to see snow from the inside of my house and not have to go out in it. I don't like driving in it, but snow in video games is one of the, like, most, like, when it snows in Minecraft, I almost always make my house in a snowy area because it's just so peaceful to me. Like, I don't know. I really enjoy it. It just makes me kind of just go, oh, and, like, think of hot chocolate and... Also, but just like sitting outside. I used to go sit outside in the snow. Like, I just sit out there because it was cold, but it was like calm and quiet. And like when snow flurries would pop up, I would totally just imagine this like snow prince would just pop out of the snow because it was just, I feel like winter is like the most magical season. I don't know. It's not my favorite, but I feel like it's the most magical season. It's the pretty, it's one of the prettiest, I think, for sure. Oh, Imshel. Where you at, Imshel? Imshel. Imshel, don't keep me waiting, Imshel. Oh, boy. Hey, buddy. Hi. Die. You die. Quick. I see you. I don't know. Ooh, buddy. Look at that. He's coming for me. Oh, my gosh. He's coming. Oh, I sort of avoided it a little bit. Not really. I need to get the high ground. High ground, high ground, high ground. High ground. Come on. Flank. High ground and flank. Gotcha. All right, Cassandra, good on ya. Can't really. Okay. You can't really see what's going on. You prefer a little bit of snow, right? I know. Last year, I think it didn't really snow where I lived until like Christmas, like the day. I think it was like 2 years ago. It like didn't snow like until like Christmas Eve, and it was like, oh, magic, you know. Ooh, nice. Jeez. Yes. Yeah. Forget what you're in. Like you're in Louisiana, right? Like, oh, buddy. Oh, hey. Have you guys were you hit by Hurricane Matthew at all? Are you guys doing okay with that? That must have also been part of the crazy week. Jeez.
At least the walk back will be easier than the walk up.
I know, right, Dorian? I'm so glad he commented on that. Dorian is the best commenter so far that I've met. Oh, yay, supply cache. Good, because we're going to fight Imshale. I can't imagine you would get snow down where you live at. Whoo, buddy, look at this. I think it... Is it rotating? I think it is. Maybe. No, maybe not. This is beautiful. In like a horrible way. But look, the lyrium, the red lyrium is strictly contained, though. Imshale knows what he's doing, somehow. What's this? Is this like a... I think it's like a helmet? Sort of a... I don't know. I remember these devices. Imshale!
Ah, the hero arrives. But is it hero or murderer? It's so hard to tell.
I want to get a closer look at you, Imshale!
Choice spirit.
Maker, give us strength.
Wait, wait, wait! These are your friends? They're very violent. It's worrying. True to my name, I will show you that you have a choice. It doesn't always have to end in blood.
A choice. True to my name, I will show you that you have a choice. You live in Ohio, off Lake Erie. Oh, hi, doggy. How's it going, doggy? Doggy, I'm about to make a deal with a demon. How about it, I think when I was very young, I visited Lake Superior, and I thought it was the ocean. I just remember now, I couldn't see the other side. It was all foggy and stuff. It was really cool. Attack! What choice?
Talk. That's how they get you. Simple. We don't fight, and I grant you power. Shower you with... Virgins.
Look at that guy over there. He's like, I'm going
then
to kill you.
We all live happily ever after. Well, not all of us, but who's counting?
Riches, power, virgins. Nope.
No. You die, demon.
Alpha. Choice. Spirit.
Hee-hee.
If you won't be smart, be afraid.
Never. Let's see what his fear demons are. Oh, just fairlings? Nice. You think you're all right? It was mostly Florida. I know there were. I heard that there were evacuations in like in Louisiana and Georgia, but Florida definitely got the hardest hit. So that's good. I'm glad that you're all right, Ashley. Whoa! Look at all these explosions. Coal's coming out of the flames, all epic like. Whoa. Imshale. I wish we could have talked more with Imshale. Dang it. He's just such an interesting dude in the book. Where's that Michael? Mm-hmm. What are you doing? Holy crap, what are you doing? Oh, I think we put barriers up too. We cannot leave. I see you. You're a rage demon now, Imshale. they chose to be here. Yeah, Zeppin King and Gax King! Gax King the Unbound. Wow, but they're dead. Are they still alive? Oh my gosh! They probably are. They probably totally are. I would not doubt it. Oh crap. Because you can, I don't think you can really kill a spirit. All you can, oh crap! Oh buddy, ooh, that was close. You can't really kill a spirit. You can destroy the form it had, but the intent will still live on. Oh no! Overreacting. Did you just... That's all he said when he died? See, I don't think he died. He wasn't showing fear that he was gonna die. You know what I mean? March of the Everlasting Amulet of Renewal. Yeah, no. I don't think we actually killed Imshale. Interesting that he called on Gax King and Zebenkick, because those are the ones that we for sure killed. Well, for sure encountered, anyway. So that might be an indication that they are still kicking it somewhere. I would not be surprised. In fact, I was kind of hoping they wouldn't be, because I'm actually pretty sure that they're connected to the old, or the forgotten gods. The, like, elven ones, you know? These are really cool. I think they're supposed to be some sort of helmet? I don't know. It's cool. I'm not sure if this is more like Tevinteri in style, like Red Templar, or if some of this was already here by the elves. But again, I get the thing is, like, Tevinter based a lot of their magic and society off of the elves, so maybe it all kind of ties together. Maybe the Tevinter kind of picked and chose some of the things they wanted. Yes, there's a little exclamation point here. Yay, stuff. I don't think I can't have that exclamation point yet. Wow, we're just picking up all the Battlemaster coats and Prowler coats and whatnot. Architecture is so beautiful. Like, it totally reminds me of, like, Paris in a way, except Paris had a lot more gold on it, like filigree type things. Or like, I don't know, not filigree so much, but it was much, like, gaudier, I guess you could say, but... Oh, hey, guy. Are you Hayden?
Is he gone? The demon is finally gone.
It won't be long now. Delirium's taken him.
Why was the demon here, working with the Red Templars?
A garden needs a gardener. Nurturing gentle hands, directing the change. Not too fast, not too slow.
I can see his face.
Just right. Has to be just right.
So you tend to Red Lyrium like a horticulturist. Interesting, if repulsive.
There's nothing I can do for you. I'm sorry.
Imshale. He said he could take the Red out. If I said yes...
Imshale could have saved you.
He liked to watch the agony. He liked to play. We were his garden. Consent and live. Deny and be consumed. Oh, but what he wanted? No. Anything but that. I chose the Red. I chose...
Yeah. I don't know. Hey, that one... I like that they do this, because it's kind of difficult to sympathize with the Templars, especially the Red Templars. I feel like this should have been sooner in the game, and maybe in areas where we had high concentrations of Templars, we should have maybe found more like him, or more notes, because they were just men and women. Some of them were just trying to do the right thing. Some of them were afraid. You know, it just... is difficult. You always hope you're making the right decision, but, you know, when you're not the player character, it's not often the right decision, and you die. Horribly. Talon, you're so beautiful! Oh my gosh, I haven't seen you in a cutscene in ages. I love you. The keep has an elfy look in places? Definitely. I got a banner. Banner did I get? Not gonna tell me? You're not going to tell me? Call me Imshare. Right, I gotta tell Michael. Where's this guy? Yo, guy.
Oh, you.
Ah, right. Guy!
Welcome. I am Baron Edouard Desjardins of Leeds. I am pleased to meet you. Ambassador Montillier speaks highly of you.
You look Ferelden, but you sound Orlesian.
You seem to know Josephine quite well.
Oh, yes. Yves Montillier, Josephine's father, is an old friend. We used to hunt together. I watched her grow up, you know.
You know?
A clever girl. She could charm wolves to dance with hares. I am gratified to see the Inquisition has not overlooked her talents.
I'm surprised I haven't gotten, like, a message from Josephine's dad or mom.
Oh, well, the ambassador entrusted me with handling the Inquisition's enterprise in the Dales. Much of our efforts are concentrated on rebuilding, eradicating threats, reopening trade routes and such. And of course, I will oversee the forging of relations with the nobles of Southern Orlais.
That's cool.
Any news, Baron?
Judicale's crossing has been rebuilt, thanks to our combined efforts.
Okay. Why do you still have an exclamation point?
Keeping busy, Inquisitor?
Any news, Baron?
We plan to push into the region to make it safe for trade and
travel. I shall take my leave.
Oh. What? Flame towers? Eh? Call me Imshale. Eh? Oh. Wow. Oh! Oh! Ha ha ha! Secure! Oh, I want to defeat that dragon. Lemonsy! Oh my god! I thought you weren't gonna be able to make it! It's very late, too! We've been streaming, like, all day! Lemonsy! I found cheese wheels! There were cheese wheels in the weirdest places! Yeah, we're in the Empress! We just got the keep! We played around. I am doing things now. I started out very slow. I know. I was actually talking to Lemon Z on Twitter. I was like, Lemon Z! Ah! Everything keeps trying to explode. And then I was like, shopping, and nothing exciting was happening. But we fought two dragons. It's 4 a.m. and you're drunk, so why the heck not come and visit us on the stream? It was definitely soft cheese. Yeah, we went to Frostback Basin. We hung out in the, we did like half the Jaws of a Con deal. Well, not half. We did a chunk of the Jaws of a Con DLC, but I was really wanting to get this keep because it's the last keep. Best way to be it for, it's a Saturday. Freaking, I don't know what it is, but I have somehow managed. Oh, they put flowers up to try to make it nice. Oh, don't put flowers up in the winter, you crazies. It's not a greenhouse. Oh, wow. Okay. Okay. So, those contraptions earlier were definitely the, like, red lyrium stuff. But how do they get those out and these back in? I haven't gotten the flower crown yet. I know. I know. It's like in the title and everything, but I'm like, I haven't actually done that yet. I love these little notice boards. It reminds me of the Chantry boards from Origins and Dragon Age 2. Look, lemons and cheese! A huge stack of cheese! Ah, I was finding cheese and I was like, oh my gosh, Lemonsy can't be here. Okay, but this, yeah, there's definitely one dragon lip. Ah, this is extremely insulting to me. When my first Inquisitor got this keep, and I understand that they're trying to replace like something that was really horrible with something that's better, but this is an Andrastian shrine in the middle of an elven ruin. Like, could you not? Could you not? Like, for realsies? And who's that? I don't know who that is. He's not an elf. He's not an elf.
We're gonna toughen you up, boy.
We're gonna toughen you up. But no, and freaking, there's so much food here. So much food. It's insane. I'm always amazed by the amount of food I see. Oh, I like his Orlesian stuff. That's nice. Wait, what's she wearing? Oh, I like that. Oh, that's the, I recognize that. I cry for the cheese. Elves live cheese. Yes, the cheese. Make a smile upon you. Oh, this upsets me that this is here. I understand that most people here are human and they probably worship, you know, Andraste, but it's very upsetting to just smack an Andrastean thing down in the middle of an elven ruin, I think. Oh, and I got, this is actually the masterwork armor that you get from the dragon, but I changed it, I changed the arms and legs and dyed it to the colors that I like. Oh, Ashley, you're playing Origins now. Ashley was already playing for a second time on Trespasser. and now she's playing Origins. What kind of character are you playing? Like, you know, of the many origin stories. What art thou playing? Ooh, Zealot Staff. What's that do? Oh, it's not that. What's that? Whoa! Master Dragon Slaying Rune. Do I have coal with me? Oh, it's not nearly as good as the other stuff I've got, but dang! Purity's light! Okay, Dorian. There's no difference between those two. Balance sunbow, winged longbow. Dude, you got a lot of things. Stand sword grip. Ooh. Masterwork stuff. Whoa! Superb cleansing rune. Holy crap. Templar. I did like the butterfly. The great sword grip on the butterfly. There are three dragons in the Empress, and I killed two of them. The one that drops the masterwork battlemaster armor, and one that drops the masterwork like prowler armor. There's a third one in the back that I've never been able to beat. The last one's for later. Yeah, Frog Raider Origins on the Xbox. Woo, buddy. Woo, buddy. It's fun. It's fun stuff. I really want to get a cool staff that is not the Lyrium staff now. I don't have anything to sell, apparently.
Anything you need, I can get.
Probably, most likely. Weapon. No, I don't want that. I also don't want any of those. Balance Sunbow, no. 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 March of the Everlasting, no, that's cool. The first time I cried like a lot. There's a dude in the camp who gave quests? What? Why, Solus? Why? He's gonna be a really interesting villain. And he better feature... They better not just have, like, an underling of his, like, running around causing trouble. Like, we better be, like... It better be, like, Solus directly that we're, like, sort of interacting with. I'm kind of hoping in the next game that it's gonna be, like, like, we're gonna start out as, like, sort of like an underling of some sort of the... Ooh, that's nice. Battlemaster coat, legs. I like those. And that brown. She looks so good. The brown and the green. She looks so nice. It's like the same thing. Whoa. Alright, we'll get rid of... Oh, they're different boots! Battlemaster male legs or Battlemaster coat legs. I like the coat legs. Get rid of that one. And we'll get rid of that one. We'll keep that one for the legs. He can be redeemed! Gosh dang it! He can be redeemed. And it better not be at the cost of my Inquisitor's life. It better not. Because there's no point. Because then it's just... I don't know. Maybe there's a point. But then Solus will be alone again. And that's how we got into the situation in the first place. Was Solus being alone and no one telling him to just, you know, just stop. Just chill out, Solus. Amulet of Renewal. Oh, you regenerated at a higher rate. That's cool.
Probably. Oh. Most likely.
Most likely. Sell all. Okay. That's decent. I guess that's it. I do love the Inquisition Baron. That was said with so much passion. Off into the fade together, making fade love. Don't you even... That's the way it's gonna be, and I refuse to allow it to end any other way. Making sweet fade love all the rest of our days. That guy's got like a face mask on. Creepy! What is up with his armor? His armor is intense! Holy crap! Thank the mech. I'm not even joking. Like, there is gonna be some way to redeem Solus. I'm pretty sure I've read some things that Patrick Weeks is like the type of person who always wants to give the players a choice. He's basically Imshael! He's basically Imshael! Oh my gosh! Wow! You two have a conversation.
I have looked over the reports. The Red Lyrium veins are well established. Given the size of the field, we have a 0.0014 chance of eliminating all of it.
Even if we dig down?
Digging taken into consideration, shards will likely remain.
So long as there's no one for it to infect.
There is life in the ground. Moles. Earthworms.
The growth will be much slower.
But still inevitable.
Hmm. I think her hair is like popping out of her hoodie. Oh, lesions, I know, right? What's with that armor? That conversation made me very depressed. The tranquil guy. I was like, shoot, is it really that bad? I mean, it's pervasive, it's everywhere. But the Empress, I don't know if there's any hope for the Empress at this point. he'll offer us virgins and he'll turn out and be like, no, because friggin' Imshale gives you a choice in everything. He gives you a choice. But the choice may be you get to live, but at the cost of another's life. Or that somebody you love lives, but at the cost of another person's life that you love, perhaps. And it doesn't always tell you what the cost will be. In the book, it was really interesting in the book, watching the way he operated. Like, he totally destroyed the Stalish clan. Literally turned them inside out, some of them. Like, he tortured each one in a different way. But he didn't kill, and this is the thing, because I knew that there were kids there, right? But then you figure out later that he did not kill the kids. He took all the children, all the Dalish children, and gave them to another clan right at the start of winter. And he said, I wonder what their choice will be after being dumped with like 20 new kids in the beginning of winter with so little food to feed them in the first place. He's like, I'm eager to see how that plays out, basically. So like, are you gonna let your own kids starve at the you know, to try to keep somebody else's kids alive? Are you gonna let all the kids starve? Because you don't have enough food to feed them all, so you give them each like a piece of biscuit and they all die? What do you do? What do you do? You still like punching Solas for? There is totally good reasons to do that, and I hope that there's actually a way, but like, it's just like, it's like, maybe he'll like wake up. You just want to shake him and be like, Solas, like, what is wrong with you? Like, what is it? The Avar, the Thane Sunhair, like Svara Sunhair, she's like, only fools try to burn the world down to save it or something. And I was just like, are you listening, Solas? Are you listening? What? If you ask for versions, oh, Imshale says something about coal? Oh! That is just, no, he's a child, he's a baby. Cole's a baby, he is fully capable adult spirit, but still, no. I think Patrick Weeks actually did like address that in an interview, like why Cole wasn't a romance option. But I didn't read it, I should, I'd like to, but. Punching Dorian's just mean. Yeah, no, we'd never punch Dorian. Never punch Dorian. But I can see, like, Solas is can be incredibly close-minded and racist and, like, elitist in many ways. And the point of that throughout the game is that with the dialogue with other people and with you, you hopefully are able to see that he's slowly learning that the way he thought about everybody is wrong. And his mind is slowly changing, and that's when Cole says, when you're romancing him, he's like, if you're real, then everybody else is real, and they can't be real, basically. And I just went the same way I just came. Awesome. Where should we go? This is a massive keep. Like, freaking, look at that. He does, like, hint towards Cole, guy. That's creepy. Creepy! That's right, I should maybe grab... What's this bucket? Oh, I need to go back to camp. Boop. You know, the romance, cool. I feel like it'd be an asexual relationship. Love and kisses is just no sex. Yeah, and that's the thing, is I think they were not wanting to do a sex scene with Cole, was the impression I got. And it would maybe, I mean, depending on how they did it, right? But I feel like a lot of the routes, you could definitely take advantage of Cole. And, like, he just wouldn't really know what was going on. And so, that, like, we totally don't want to do that, right? Like, that's not okay. But, I mean, yeah, it would be more like an asexual relationship, perhaps. I like that. Like, that would be fine. But, wow. What?
No. I dropped it. It's gone.
I'm trying to talk to you.
Alas, ring. You found it. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'll never let it go again.
Okay.
I like it when we help people.
Okay, Cole. I forgot Cole was with me. Hi, Cole. But he doesn't learn enough to change Solas. Doesn't learn enough to change his mind. Is that what you were saying? Yeah. But the thing is, if you become friends with him, or if like you're really good friends with him, or if you're romancing him, he wants you to stop him. He's basically doing everything he can.
No sign of trouble at the moment.
He is basically. Oh my gosh, Celine is dead. I forgot. Wow. Did I? Oh, I talked to you. It's fine. Okay.
It's done. The demon is dead.
It is finally over. I wish I could have heard him scream, but Sarnia.
He didn't scream, dude. He's still kicking it somewhere.
Now I find myself free to choose a new direction. I would be honored to serve the Inquisition, if it will have me.
Heck yeah, man.
The Inquisition welcomes you, Michel de Chavan.
I shall return to your outpost.
Wow, wait, for reals? Can I still talk to you? Because I want to talk to you about, Celine. How can I forget I killed the Empress? Ah! Yeah, there is no sex scene for Josie, which is kind of a bummer, too. Like, I don't know. There's no sex scene for Solas, so, you know, I can't complain. I am really glass half full when it comes to Solas. I am, but the funny thing is that I see a lot of, like, Solas critical things, and they make a ton of valid points. It's just that I hate to leave anybody behind, you know what I mean? Like, I hate to, like, just... Like, I redeemed Anders, you know, and Anders basically blew up. I mean, he basically did a small version of what Solas is doing, except much less, is much smaller, but still. We're squirrels. It was only Tuesday. Okay. I am too naive in love. I am.
No sign of trouble at the moment.
Empress Celine is dead.
Ah, the game is merciless. I wish I could have said goodbye. Perhaps if I had been there, she... Regret upon regret. What's one more? The Grand Duke has the throne. Gaspard will make a good emperor in his own way.
Yeah, except It's funny because that noble earlier was trying to speak Elven to appease the powers in Halamshiral. And it's because people know, they must know somehow that Briala has, like, a tight leash on Gaspard. No, I totally get, like, there actually is somebody that I follow a bit that they tend to post, not a lot, but they'll post something that aggravates them about Solas, and I do it on purpose because I don't want to just be like, Solas is the best thing ever. He has major flaws.
Ground here. I'm picturing myself bumping all the way down a mountain.
Well, now that's all I'm gonna see this whole time. Just Dorian taking a tumble down the mountain. Oh, that's so funny. Wolves. You like the war table mission to reunite Michael and Celine? Aww! Ah, because that's the thing. I think Celine probably wouldn't have died if Michael was with her. Like, he's a baddie. He's really good at keeping her safe. Briala, funnily enough, is not a Fen'Harel agent. Hilariously enough. Actually, in Trespasser at the end... Remember, Solas says that he had to basically take control of the Alluvians himself because Briala had control over them. She had the passwords. She created the passwords, basically, and had control over this certain section of Alluvians. And Solas sent somebody to try to get the passwords, but he failed. So Solas had to go in himself and take them from her. Which, I don't know what's happened to Briala, if that's the case. But, yeah, with the Alluvians, in the book, she was actually being sort of manipulated by an agent of Fen'Harel, but then in the end, the agent of Fen'Harel chose to not try to take control over the Alluvians from Briala, and Solas ended up having to do that himself, apparently. Well, did she give them to him? Because in my version of Trespasser with Erica, he had to take them from her. He had to physically go, or like he had to go to each Illuvian and like wrest the power from her with the mythol powers that he gets. Interesting. I wonder if it'll change. Because with Erica, I had Selene and Briala reunited, but in this one, it'll be Briala controlling Gaspard. And I wonder if that will affect how the Illuvians get handed over. That should be interesting. Like, oh man, you're a god, okie dokie. Funny thing is, Briala actually, in the books anyway, she really actually admires Fen'Harel, which is freaking hilarious. Like, I read the book after playing Inquisition, and I was rolling. I was like, oh! Like, I was like, there's so many clues in this book.